Shalom, 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 shalom. All praises, honor, glory to our power, Yahawah, our Heavenly Father, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Rawchaa, Qadash. All praises, honor, glory to our power, Yahawah. Yahawah is our Heavenly Father, the power of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and the Redeemer of Israel, the conquering lion from the tribe of Judah, the one coming in the chariot and to redeem his elect family. Oh, this world, family, they are losing their mind, but they haven't seen anything yet. All praises, honor, glory to the power of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Family, the power of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. His name is Yahawah. And our heavenly Father, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi. Family, I'm too excited to even get a name out, eh? But yes, Yahawashi, family, is coming. And before he does, family, the entire world, family, we are what? Doing what? Casting down the imagination of this wicked nation. That's what we're going to get into. But let's give proper honor to our power. All praises, honor, glory to our power, Yahawah. And his only begotten son, the Redeemer of Israel, the conquering lion from the tribe of Judah, Yahawashi. To the elect of Israel, the so-called Latinos, the so-called blacks, the so-called Negroes, African-American, whatever name that the oppressor put on us, family, this entire world is about to know who the true children of the Lord is. Yes. Yes. You are not black. You are not Negroes. You're not African-American. These are all the names that the oppressor put on us. You are the Hebrew Israelite. Yes. Family, you can't. The truth is like a lion. Somebody made this quote. The truth is like a lion. It doesn't need to be defended. Just let it loose. It shall defend itself. Family, let's get into it. Again, it's your brother Malak. Shalom, 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 shalom. Let's get into it, family. I hope this lesson is not too long. But we see where the spirit moves me. Yes. It's another beautiful day to give honor and glory to our power, Yahawah Bahashem, for putting this beautiful song in our mouth. Eh? Because we are living in the last days. This is the good news, the gospel for the kingdom which is coming. It's going to be on this planet Earth. That's right. Yahawashi is going to be in the midst of us. He's the one that's going to gather the elect onto the ship and take them home. That's right. We ain't writing no decree, eh? To go get on a plane and then take over the line and say, oh yeah, we are home now. No. Family, we are going out in style, family. That's right. Yahawashi is going to take us to our land in style. Yes, get that through your head. Don't buy no plane. No, family. We're sitting back. So, family, let's get into it. Oh, yes. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Let's pick it up from verse 4. It says, for the weapons of our warfare. Listen carefully. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. Family, we don't need machine guns. We don't need knives. We don't need airplane, fighter jets. No. All we are doing is speaking the truth. And didn't the Lord says what? He shall consume them with what? The spirit of his mouth. Who do you think the Lord is talking to? He's talking about the prophets. First, the Lord is going to use his prophet, right? And pull down the veil. That's right. And then he's coming. He's coming in his brightness. Yes. And he's going to bring the missiles, the lasers, to destroy these nations, their kingdom, everything attached to them. But first, family, we, the prophets, have to speak. We are the mouth, the spirit of the Lord, speaking right now, telling you that the kingdom is at hand. Let's get it. It says, verse 4, 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4, it says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through who? Our power. To the what? Pulling down strongholds. What are some of these strongholds? You have to ask yourself. Eh? The fact that you, the elect of Israel, you've been named after who? You've been named after two people. Let's say, for example, African-American. Africa is named after who? Scipio Africanus, right? That is a Roman general. Eh? And then what? And America. America is named after who? Amerigo Vespucci, right? Another Italian merchant. That's right. So you, the elect, Israel, have been named, especially African-American, have been named after who? Two Edomites. These are the strongholds. These are the lies that what? We have to pull down. The veil is coming off. These nations are going to know who the true people are. Let's continue. It says here, casting down imaginations. This entire world has been fooled, family. Entire world has been fooled. Right? They keep giving themselves to them. We are Europeans. We are Italian. We are Portuguese. We are this. We are that. We are Germans. Family, they are the Edomites of the book. These are the stronghold. All these imaginations that, family, they continue to use. These are all the lies. But the Lord is about to remove. The Lord is removing it. Before the Lord brings the punishment, family, before the Lord judges this nation, it's like the court of law. And you go to the court, you have the defense, you have the prosecutor, family, everybody present their evidence. Eh? Before the judge make a decision, guess what? He has to see the evidence. All your lies, we know how you got this land. The North American, all the treaty, all the wicked treaties that you signed with the Northern tribe, the tribe of God, when you came on this land, so-called America. Family, how did they get the land? You have to ask yourself, these are the strongholds. These are all the lies, robbery, eh? Robbery, murder. That's why he says the land has to be cleansed by the blood of those that shed it. You can get that in the book of Numbers. When they got here, guess what? The northern tribe received them. Well, but their family, but it says what? It says what? It says what? But war was in his heart. That's what they are known for. Deceit, lie, corruption. Let's go. It says here, casting down imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of our power and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of the Most High, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi. They are pseudoscience. Eh? Family, they are pseudoscience. This is what they've been using to fool the masses. Eh? The word black and white, family, look it up. 1681. Right? 1681 in Virginia. That's when they wrote that into law. They placed those names on us. They call us black. Eh? They call themselves white. We know these are all the strongholds that we are pulling down. Eh? These are all the imagination. The entire world, family, is upside down. But the time has come. The reason why all this truth is coming out, eh? Because the Lord is presenting his evidence. Exhibit A, Exhibit B, Exhibit C. So when he brings the judgment, nobody can say that the Lord is not righteous. It says the entire creation is waiting for the manifestation of the children of the Most High, Yahawah Bahashem. What do you think that means? It's not just us waiting to be changed with our new bodies. Even the animals, they don't have a place to call their own. Even the trees, family, they said when we go back, it says what? The trees shall rejoice. And the world is going to be in harmony. Eh? This is what everybody's waiting for. The Lord gave you an opportunity to rule. Eh? But you use your what? Your blessing, which was what? The sword. Family, this book don't lie. Esau's blessing was the sword. Esau is the Edomite. Esau's name was changed to Edom. They are the one in rulership. The head ruler is who? Amalek. The so-called small heart, the 1948ers. The one living on the land right now. But the Lord said what? The land has to be trodden down by the Gentiles until their time be fulfilled. So they are doing exactly what the Lord asked them to do. That's why, family, we are casting down imaginations. All the truth, family, you can't do anything against the truth. Eh? This is the Lord's movie. This is the Lord's movie. He's the one that wrote the script. Everybody's playing their part. Family, let's go to another precept here. Let's go to the book of 2 Thessalonians. Second Thessalonians chapter 2. Let's pick it up from verse 8. And it says here, and then shall the wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth. That's what we're doing right now. That's what we're doing right now. The spirit of the Lord's mouth. Eh? We're telling you everything that you have done. All your wickedness, how you got this world. Eh? How you use your sword to go around the world pillaging, raping, stealing, corruption. Eh? All in the name of what? Democracy. But you don't even believe in it. Eh? You don't even believe in it. If you're speaking the truth right now in America, they shut you down. Why? Why? Eh? Speaking the truth right now is becoming what? A revolutionary. Eh? But it's the Lord that is doing it. There's nothing you can do against this truth. You can't do anything against this truth. It has to come out. It has to come out. It says here, and then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth. That's what we're doing right now. And shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. Yahawashi. That's the brightness of his coming. The thousands and thousands and thousands of chariots that are coming. The so-called UFOs. That's right. These are what? Eh? These are the stronghold. The chariot, you know they are the chariot, but you what? You say it's UFOs, unidentified, eh? Flying objects. No! But the entire world is going to know what those UFOs are. Those are the Lord's chariots. The angels are not green creature with big head and small eyes, whatever you want to describe in some alien. No. They are angels. And you're going to see them. You're going to see them. Our brothers and they are coming. Michael, you think Michael the archangel is going to come looking like some green creature? No, you're going to see. You're going to see him. You're going to see him. These are all the covering cards. These are all the lies that we are pulling down through the spirit. All praises to our power, Yahawah. Bahasham, Yahawashi. Hey, the covering cast has been removed. Family, we are living in an information age, family. Wake up. The information is out there. You have to look at it. You got to look for it. Eh? You are not black. You are not African-American. This is for the elect. Eh? You are not Negroes. You are not Jamaican. You are not Caribbean. You are not native. No. You are the Israelite, the Hebrew Israelite. And yes, the Lord is coming. Our Lord, Yahawashi, is coming. But before he comes, this is what we have to do. Hey? We have to consume you. Hey? With the spirit of the Lord telling you that your kingdom is coming to an end and a righteous kingdom is coming. That's right. A righteous kingdom is coming. Because so far you've been like what? 0400 for the past 500 years? Yes. So there's a new coach coming, a new ruler, and he's coming. He's coming to change the whole team. Right? He's coming to change the whole team. He's bringing new players. Revelation 14, 144,000 governors. That's right. 12,000 from each tribe. Going to be ruling under Yahawashi. And this earth, this planet is going to be righteous. That's the new team that he's bringing in. The elect. Yes. And a large multitude. Women. Women, pregnant women. Eh? Women with children. Eh? The lame, the blind. Oh, the Lord is going to have mercy on a lot of our people. The elect, the Israelite family, all praises, honor, glory to our power, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi. This is the good news. Yes, it says go. It says here. It says verse 9, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 9. It says, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders. His what? His science, his pseudoscience, his AI technology. Eh? He uses his media to push his propaganda. Eh? He controls everything. Eh? But guess what? The Lord is about to destroy it all. All praises to our power, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi. Eh? All praises, honor, glory to our power, Yahawah, Bahasham. We want righteousness. Yes, that's what is coming. Righteousness. You'll be able to identify a man from a girl. Eh? Hey, a boy from a girl, family. In America, at least, family, in 10 states, you can have sex with an animal. What kind of nonsense is that? Hey, what kind of nonsense is that? Hey, This place is worse than Sodom and Gomorrah. That is why the Lord is coming. That's that the Lord is coming. Oh, that's the Lord is coming. We're not going to hold our peace until the Lord establishes once again. It says, they that make mention of the Lord, it says, hold not thy peace until what? He makes Jerusalem a praise on this planet. It says, give him no, it says, give him no what? Give him no rest. We're going to continue to praise the name Yahawah and his only begotten son Yahawashi until he makes Jerusalem a praise on this planet. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go to the book of Isaiah, family. Isaiah 25. Isaiah 25, 7. Oh, Isaiah, where are you, Isaiah? Isaiah 25, verse 7. Let's go straight to the point. It says here, and he, who is he, Yahawah, will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people. Hey? And the veil that is spread over all nations. Your wickedness, the veil, eh? The covering cast, eh? Your democracy, everything that you pushed on this nation, eh? Painting yourself as what? A beacon of light. The Lord says what? He's going to remove it. The nation's actually going to know who truly you are, who America is, who these Edomites are, the ruling party, who they are. The Lord says he's going to remove all the covering cast. These nations are going to see who. They're going to know who you are, eh? Yes, they're going to know who you are, how you got your riches, eh? Knowing that everything that you've been pushing around the world is nothing but it's nothing but demonic wickedness, corruption, thievery, everything that you've gotten, eh? Today you are in Iraq, tomorrow Afghanistan, eh? Libya, Syria, all in the open. Because why? You have the sword. That was your blessing. The blessing that Isaac, our forefather, gave you, that by the sword thou shalt live. That's why you have over 850 army bases across the world. Nobody can say anything. You go there, you have what? Grenade in one hand, and the other hand, you have a so-called democracy. And by the time you finish raping, pillaging, stealing, eh, you left them holding the bag. But the Lord is removing the covering cast. Eh? That's why right now, you have no idea what is happening to you. Your nation, everything is breaking down. You know why? Your time has come. That's it. It's that simple. Your time has come. Let's go. Isaiah 26 verse 7. Let's repeat that again. It says, and he will destroy in this mountain, eh, the face of the covering cast over all people. The covering cast. Eh? You fool all this nation. Eh? Eh? You're trying to push your ideology, eh? The American way, the European way, whatever you want to call it. And they destroy their tradition. Eh? They've forgotten their own ways and they're following you, the whole. Because why? You have the power in your hand. You can allow it. If they refuse to follow your laws and your decrees, guess what? You remove the leaders and then you put in a puppet government. You don't think the Lord is keeping score. But before Yahawashi comes, he says what? The spirit of his mouth, which are what? The prophets. They have to condemn you before the Lord comes. And when he's coming with the brightness of his countenance. Family, what the Lord is about to do to this planet, it's not going to be easy. The day of the Lord is gloominess, it's darkness. This is what the Lord is coming to do. Eh? Because family, this world here needs a new leadership. Yes. The world needs a new leadership. Let's bring out the precept. Let's bring out the precept, family, and glorify our power because this is his movie. It says here, let's go to 2 Ezra. 2 Ezra chapter 6. Where is it? Let's go straight to the point, family. I think it's around 28. Yes, it says here. So after the Lord removed all the covering cast, eh? And when Yahawashi comes, this is what the Lord is saying. He says here, for evil, eh? It's for evil shall be put out. Hmm? Deceit shall be let's repeat that again. It says, 2 Ezra chapter 6, verse 27. It says, for evil shall be put out, and deceit, lies, family, shall be quenched. Verse 28, it says, as for faith, it says what? It shall flourish. Corruption shall be overcome. And the truth which have been so long without fruit shall be declared. The truth has been declared right now. Eh? The truth has been declared right now, and they are so afraid. Corruption, family, all over government. Eh? During this past two and a half years, with the so-called, you know, the jab, family, people have lost their jobs. Eh? But family, it was an experiment. It was an experiment. They've destroyed people's life. That's corruption. That's wickedness. That's family. That's why we need a new rulership. The king is coming to rule in righteousness. It says here, let's repeat verse 20. It says, ask for faith. It shall flourish. Corruption shall be overcome. And the truth, which have been so long without fruit, shall be declared. There's no truth in this world, family. Everything is a lie. Everything, the media, the news, whatever they feed the family, everything is a lie. Hey? Our food and the water that we drink, our communities. Hey? You're paying taxes, but family, things just continue to remain the same. This is why we need a new rulership. Let's go to Habakkuk 2, straight to the point. Let's go to verse 15. Yeah, it says here, verse 14. It says here, Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 14. It says, for the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of our power. You listening to this? Hey? It says here, as the waters cover the sea, eventually, this is what's going to happen. It says here, but woe unto him that giveth his neighbor drink. What is the Lord saying here? The Lord is saying that his neighbor drink. What drink is he talking about? This his philosophy. Hey? He's coming to tell you whatever you are doing in your country is not enough. This is how I want you to run your country. Hey? I'm giving you democracy. And you have to push these laws. All these wicked laws. And all this abomination lifestyle. This is what I want you to push. This is the drink that the Lord is saying. He says here, for the earth, again, verse 15, Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 15. It says, woe unto him that giveth his neighbor drink, that putteth the bottle to him, and maketh him drunk also, that thou mayest look on their nakedness. You see? Because when they come and give you your philosophy, their philosophy, and then you push it in your society, guess what? And then your society becomes just like them. Eh? Wickedness. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay to marry a tree. Yes, right. It's okay to have sex with animals. Yes. This is their philosophy. Eh? And now you are in sin. That's your nakedness. Nakedness is your sins. But the Lord is about to. It says, family. Here, verse 16. It says here, thou art filled with shame for glory. Eh? It says here, drink down also, and let thy foreskin be uncovered. The cup of the Lord's right hand shall be turned unto thee, and shameful spewing shall be on thy glory. Eh? America the Great. Eh? Look at this. We are Europeans. Look at this. Yes. We achieve this. We achieve that. Yeah. How did you achieve all those things? And because we know that in Europe, there's no resource in Europe. How is France built up? France. Britain. What was their role in slave trade? Eh? Congo. Eh? Patrice Lumumba. Eh? Sankara. All these leaders that wanted something for their nation. Eh? What did you do to them? Eh? Because what? They were looking for the interests of their people. Guess what? You brought in your sword. Eh? You caused coup. You removed them. You steal their resources. Eh? You give them this high interest loan that they can never pay. IMF, family. This is what the Lord is about to do. The Lord kept all the evidence, eh? All the wickedness that you have done. The Lord remembered all of it. Eh? That's why that shameful glory, that shameful spewing is going to be on your glory. Eh? The entire world is going to know how you got your riches. Eh? This is exactly what is happening right now. Eh? And those who are living on that land, I guess they forgot to read the Bible. That land, whatever they are doing, is the will of the Lord. The Lord says what? That land has to be trodden down by the Gentile family. Look it up. Somewhere in Luke. Okay? Until what? That their time be fulfilled. It is the Lord that's going to remove them from that land. So this week, 2 weeks ago, right now, the biggest thing is Kanye West. What he said, that what he is the true, he says the so-called black are the true Israelite. He's not lying. But they're going to make it seem like he has lost his mind. But that's okay though. You can't do nothing against this truth. You can't. You cannot do nothing against this truth. The Lord is using him. Family, don't get it twisted. It says that the deceiver and the deceived are both his. Everything that is happening right now, it was meant to happen. It was meant to happen. This year, by him saying that, somebody, one of the elect, is going to hear it and is going to say, guess what? He's going to do the research and he's going to realize that, oh, after all, I am the apple of the Lord's eye. Somebody's going to hear it. They're going to wake up. Family, listen, the Lord, the power that the Lord has, family, is what? Infinite. That's why he's known as what? The omnipotent, family. That's the power that we serve. There's nothing you can do against this truth. Absolutely nothing. Hey, let's go. Let's see what principle I have here. Let's go to Isaiah 47. Isaiah 47, family. Let's glorify the Lord, man. Let's glorify the Lord. Isaiah 47. Here. Let's pick it up from verse 5. It says, Isaiah 47, verse 5 says, sit thou silent and get thee into darkness, O daughter of the Chaldeans. For thou shalt no more be called the lady of kingdoms. You hear that? The Lord is speaking to you. Family, yes. The Lord is speaking to you. The Edomites, eh? The ruling party, the Amalek, the head tribe. That's right. The so-called, the 1948, the small hearts. The Lord is speaking to you. It says here, verse 6. It says, I was wroth with my people. Eh? Who are the lost people? The Israelites. It says, I have polluted mine inheritance and given them into thy hand. Thou didst show them no mercy. Upon the ancient hast thou very heavily laid thy yoke. That's right. The burden that you put on us. The Lord said, you showed us no mercy. Eh? The plantation, the transatlantic slave trade. Most of our people couldn't make it across the ocean. Family, they died on their way to the plantations. You think the Lord forgot all this? No, he didn't forget it. Eh? The Lord is taking off the covering cast. All this nation, they're going to know who the Israelites are, family. This is the Lord's movie. This is the Lord's movie. Let's continue. It says here. Verse 7. It says, Isaiah 47, verse 7. It says, and thou said, I shall be a lady forever. Eh? Because you thought you're going to rule forever. But listen to this. So thou did not lay these things to thy heart, neither did remember the latter end of it. Because when you are living good, everything is going on well for you. Right? The Lord, you don't think about the Lord. You honestly think your kingdom is gonna go on forever. But you forgot to read the book of Daniel. Daniel told you exactly all this kingdom that will come and rule, and at the end Yahawashi is coming to destroy it and establish his own kingdom. You forgot to read that. But guess what? The Lord didn't give you that wisdom. Eh? Because you were not smart enough. You didn't have this wisdom. No. So when you had the apple of the Lord's eyes in your hands, you mistreated them. Yeah, raping them, pillaging, stealing. You came here to North America. The so-called native, the tribe of God, they receive you nicely and only for you to turn around, destroy them, and push them into the plantation. Push them into reservation. Fill their community with drugs. That's right. But you never thought your end will come. You see how the Lord works? You never thought your end will come. Here, it says here, and thou said, I shall be a lady forever. So thou did not lay these things to thine heart, neither did remember the latter end of it. Therefore, hear now this. Thou that are given to pleasure, thou dwellest carelessly. You hear that? The Lord knows you. You know that you dwellest carelessly? Hey, look at America. Look at, you can do whatever your heart desires. Hey, you don't care. Hey, you can do whatever. Family, you can worship anything that you want. You can eat whatever you want. Hey, today you can wake up today and say you're a boy. Tomorrow you can say you're a girl. This is what the Lord is saying about you. Hey, it says here, therefore hear this now, that are given to pleasures, that dwellest carelessly. Okay, so carelessly. He says, that sayest in thine heart, I am and none else beside me. I shall not sit as a widow, neither shall I know the loss of children. But these two things shall come to thee in a moment, in one day. The loss of children and widowhood, they shall come upon thee in their perfection, for the multitude of thy sorceries and for the great abundance of thine enchantment. What's the Lord saying there? Because you never thought you're going to have any hardship. Eh? Yeah, you never thought. You thought, oh, your kingdom is going to go on forever. Your kids, you can pass on your riches onto your children. You see, you never thought about this, but the Lord is saying that, yes, everything that you didn't think was going to happen to you, they're going to come in their perfection. This is what the Lord is saying. That's right. This is what the Lord is saying. It says here, it says, oh, so your enchantment. What's your enchantment? Your TV, your movies, eh? Your commercials, trying to continue to deceive people. Now the biggest thing is AI. AI can allow you to have will allow you to communicate with your dead ones. Family, these people, they are wary in their sorcery. Family, they are wary in their multitude of sorcery. Family, let's bring that. Let's bring it. Before I butcher it, just let's go to Isaiah 47 again. Isaiah 47. They said thou are wary in the multitude of their sorcery. Where is that? I think Isaiah 47, 13. It says here. Isaiah 47, 13. It said, thou art weary in the multitude of thy counsels. It says here, let now the astrologers, eh? The stargazers, the monthly prognosticators stand up and save thee from these things that shall come upon thee. Yeah. Your think tanks. That's right. Your witchcraft. Eh? Oh, you're so elite. Let them tell you. Eh? Let them help you. The Lord is saying, the Lord is mocking you. Let them help you. Eh? Because the Lord says what? All the wickedness, all the things that you didn't think was going to happen to you, the collapse of your society, eh? The loss of children, widowhood, it says they will come in their perfection. Eh? That's why he's asking you, go get your stargazers, your think tanks, eh? Your elite from these best universities. Let them help you. Let them help you. This is it, family. This is it. This is the good news. This is the good news, family. The kingdom is at hand. The kingdom is at hand. Yahawashi is coming to establish his kingdom. That's right. A new judge is going to be in town, family. Hey, a new coach, family. Bringing a whole bunch of different players. Because you have been old for how many years? Old for 400, 500 plus years. When you came back in the 1400s. Eh? The rebirth, the renaissance. Eh? Look at the earth. All you have to do, look at the earth, family. Are people rejoicing? Are people enjoying themselves? Eh? Look at the chaos, the uproar of the people. Eh? Look at the ocean, island of garbage. Eh? The animals are the fish. The family, nobody's at rest. Nobody's at rest. Because why? Esau is still on top. Esau is still ruling. And Esau needs to be removed. And Jacob put on top. And that's when this earth is going to see peace. And that is what is coming. Yahawashi is coming. It says here, let's bring another precept, family. Let's bring another precept. Oh, family, the covering cast, family, is coming off. You can't fool anybody anymore. You haven't ruled in righteousness. Oh, no. The king is coming. The king Yahawashi is coming. He's bringing the fire. You haven't ruled in righteousness. Eh? Family, like I said, you can't do anything against this truth. You can't do anything against this truth. 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 8. You can't do anything against this truth. Acts chapter 5, verse 38. Let's get out. Acts chapter 5, verse 38. Oh, where is it? Acts chapter 5, 38, family. Oh, we love the Lord. We love the Lord. It says here, Acts chapter 5, verse 38, it says here, and now I say unto you, refrain from these men. That's right. The prophets out there pushing this gospel, the truth, you can't do anything against us. Oh, no. Because it's the truth. It's the truth. This is the Lord's movie. He says here, Acts chapter 5, verse 30, it says, and now I say unto you, refrain from these men and let them alone. For if this counsel or this work be of men, it will come to naught. But if it be of the Most High, ye cannot overthrow it, lest haply ye be found even to fight against our power. You think it is my will to be here? No. That's what it's saying. There's nothing you can do about this truth here. The Lord bless you. He said you're going to have the dew of heaven. You live in the best places. Eh? Some of these nations, you went there, pillaged them, removed them from their land, and took it upon yourself. Then the Lord says that nobody should remove the ancient landmarks. Then what the Lord said that? But you did it. You did it anyways. You named this nation. You went and changed the name. Today you call it Italy. You call it Rome. You call it German. Eh? You call it all these names that the Lord, the biblical name, you've removed them. Eh? You've removed them. But you didn't know the time will come when these nations are going to know who they truly are, not the name that you have given them. Esau, come on. Come on. Come on. The Chinese, they are not Chinese. They are the Moabites. Eh? The Japanese, they are what? They are the Ammonites. And the so-called Indians, they are what? The Temanites. But you have changed the name, right? To hide yourself. No, you can't hide. Esau, you can't hide. You cannot hide. It says here, you cannot hide. You cannot hide. It says here, I love this here, family. Let's get it. We might as well get it. Let's go to Romans. Romans chapter 8. I quoted it earlier. I might as well bring it up. Romans 8. Please bear with me. Romans 8. Let's pick it up from 22. It says, for we know. Romans chapter 8, verse 8, verse 22. Romans 8, verse 22 says, for we know that the whole creation, family, not just us, the animals, the tree, everything that was created. It says here, for we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. It says here, and not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits, the elect. That's right, the elect are the first fruit, family, of the Spirit. Even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our body, this body here. Okay, listen to this. Our body has to be changed. That's right, that's what we're waiting for. I said, for we are saved by hope, but hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man seeth, why does he yet hope for? But if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. Likewise, the Spirit also help our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groaning, which cannot be uttered. Family, the entire creation, not just us, is waiting for the manifestation. It says here, let's go to here. It says, verse 29, it says, from whom did he foreknow? He also did predestinate to him to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Family, you know that the elect were picked before the foundation of the earth. Basically, that's what it's saying. It says, moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified. What shall we say then to these things? If the Most High be for us, who can be against us? Eh? Who can be against us? Eh? We all waiting to be changed. At the end of the day, we all waiting to be changed. We all waiting to be changed. The family, the covering cast is being removed. The covering cast is being removed. The biggest thing this week and a half is being Kanye West, whatever his name is. Yeah. The family, that was whether it is set up to bring another draconian law into place. Who cares? Because the time will come where this word here is going to be shut down. We know that it's coming. They're going to remove us from the internet, whatever social media platform that we are on. They're going to remove the word. Yes, they're going to have to take it down eventually. The famine of the word is coming because it was also prophesied that the famine of the world will come. Okay? But at this point, family, there's the Lord. That the Lord is controlling everything. The Lord is controlling everything. But let's finish off. Let's finish off the book of Hosea, Hosea 1. Let's go to the book of Hosea. Hosea chapter 1, verse 10. It says here, yet the number, listen to this, yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea, which cannot be measured nor numbered. And it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, listen to this, listen to the next verse, yea, ye are not my people, there it shall be said unto them, yea, ye are the sons of the living power. That's spiritual. Because we know Kanye West changed his name to Ye. I think it's Ye. Family, our warfare is not carnal. It's not carnal. You have to see things in the spiritual. Everything here that we do, it's all spiritual, family. It's all spiritual. But these people, they will never understand it. The bacon, anybody can say that they are the people of the Lord. But the moment Israel come out and say we are, then there's a big controversy. Why is that? Why is that? Because, family, we know that this nation, family, they are not out there to look for our interest. No. That's how the Lord set it up. Family, the only one that's going to get the credit on that day is the Redeemer of Israel. His name is Yahawashi. And he is the one that is coming to get us out of this place. Family, nothing happened by an accident. Nothing happened by an accident. No, everything that's happening was meant to happen. So family, the lesson was what? The lesson was pulling down stronghold. Let's finish with that again. Let's go back to Corinthians. Second Corinthians 10. Second Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4. It says here, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. It's not carnal, family, but mighty through the power to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of our power, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of our Hamashiach Yahawashi. Family, it doesn't matter what they do, eh? We are going to sit tight and wait upon our Lord, because he told us he's the one that's going to rise up to the prey. That's right. These nations are going to know who the children are. The children of the Most High, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, the Israelite. These nations are going to know. Eh? They're going to know. The Lord is going to reveal to this nation. He's removing the covering cast. Eh? The one these nations, Esau, have used to deceive the entire world. Eh? 1948, they made a declaration. They're going to take over the land. That's okay. Fill your boot. Because it was already prophesied that the land has to be trodden down by the Gentiles. So what are we doing? What are we doing? We just want to say honor and glory to our power, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Qadash. Family, I will leave it there. I hope you were edified. Shalom. Okay, so let them enjoy the land. We will go home. We will go home. The Lord, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, is sending Yahawashi to come and get us and take us home. They are fulfilling prophecy right now. They are supposed to be on that land. until that time comes. All praises, honor, glory to our power, Yahawah. Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, and Qadash. Family, I hope you were edified. Shalom.